Praise be to the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of compassion and the God of all comfort, who comforts us all in our troubles, so that we can comfort those in any trouble with the comfort we receive ourselves from God. For just as the sufferings of Christ flow into our lives, so also through Christ our comfort overflows. If we are distressed, it is for our comfort and salvation. If we are comforted, it is for our comfort, which produces in our patience endurance of the same suffering we suffer. And our hope in you is firm, because we know that just as you share in our suffering, so also you share in our comfort. Amen.
Thank you.
All
leaders are free to join. Women's Ministry executive would also like to thank everyone who was able to make it yesterday, and they say God bless you. There will be a safeguard in our house training. She said, why are we interested, guys? On the 5th of November. And our women ministry superstar that will be out to sell and drop into the bank. And there's also businesses. JJ Electronics, Mr. Big Eli Service, and if Mr. Big Black Pastor was an email. Come on,
Today is a joyful day. Not only for the quiet day, but it's also the day of the Lord. Sometimes we focus all our attention on a bad day, and I forget that it is the day of the Lord. It's unto you, and I will also thank the pastor and the leadership of the church. And I also thank the choir leaders for giving this privilege. It is an honor to stand here and minister.
Amen.
In fact, they are doing a great job. Emboy Simon. For the invitations, the time that is spent for the Lord. Sometimes, especially instrumentals, they are coming here every day. Sometimes they are not too much on the homework. They have sacrificed themselves, their time for the work of God. They need appreciation. Give them appreciation. Clap for them. Hallelujah. Very soon we'll have a new instrument, a drummer. He said, a new drummer. By 2 years, the man will be taken over. Jesse forever. So we are the backbone of the church. That are the youth that Pinya shall see. And sometimes all can and sassy. But the children move the land all canoe. And pastor, you know, the beautiful and all can some change. When you go to Ghana, some are pastors, deacons, leaders. So this is how God works. We need to allow the youth to take over. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Pastor, most of you, so for watching our heart. Most of you at the same time is not a madam for. I am down for more than 25 years. The man also has a tumor as dating for more than 10 years. So you know me and I know him. Yes, I saw us not waiting, you know. Yes, I saw if you we were 9 people. But now when you go to Italy, that church is the biggest church in Italy. We have bought a big house for the Lord. So I know that God will give this house to us, just as He gave to us in Italy. The ministry of power for her. So something can our cover that. So I will not waste my time. But join me for your Bible. May you read and can 2 Chronicles chapter 5, verse 11 into 14. All the priests who were there had consecrated themselves, regardless of their divisions. All the Levites who were musicians, which is why we all their musicians, shall say, Asaph, Heman, Jeduthun, and their sons and relatives stood on the east side of the altar, dressed in linen and praying shambles, harps, and Elilias. They were accompanied by 120 priests sounding trumpets. It's stating, the trumpeters and the musicians joined in unison to give praise and thanks to the Lord, accompanied by trumpet, chambers, and other trumpets. The singers raised their voices in praise to the Lord and sang, He is good. And his love endures forever. Then the temple of the Lord was filled with a crowd. Verse 14, the last verse. And the priests could not perform their service because of the crowd. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Okay, online, but you might better not to another pay. So you can join me as I worship Him. Oh, heaven, declare the glory of the Lord. suffering with a beauty of the Lord. You are the Lamb who was slain, and now you have risen and seated at the right hand of God. May your name be glorified this morning. May your name be exalted this morning. You have conquered the grave, and you have conquered it. To whom you be like you, you are the Alpha and Omega. You are the one yesterday, today, and forever. This morning, all that we can say is the name be glorified. We thank you for the opportunity you have come, you have given to us to come before your presence. I pray, Father Lord, and ask the Holy Spirit to take absolute control. I am just a vessel that you have chosen to minister to your people. I pray the Lord that you grant me the boldness. I pray that you speak for me. Your ways is an entrance of the way you will like, and give understanding to the simple. May your way, Lord, have a way in your people. Prepare the heart of your people so that they can receive your word with gladness. Enemy, you don't have any portion in this service. Therefore, I command you to pray in the name of Jesus. I command you to pray in the name of Jesus. Holy Ghost, the moment has come. Have your own way in the name of Jesus. I pray, amen. I have entitled my message, The Importance of Music in the House of God.
Amen.
Because today is the day for the choir. And as we are celebrating our Lord, I think it will be an opportunity to talk to you about how music takes role in the house of God.
Amen.
Because most of believers don't understand the importance of music. Why God wants us to worship Him and praise Him. So we do it anyhow. We do it anyhow. Sometimes some people will come to church. They will stay home and come to church late. Only to come and meet the word of God. But music takes a major role in the house of God. I believe that before I end my message, you will know how you are going to praise God and worship God from now on.
Amen.
Okay, amen.
Amen.
We know David as a man after God's own heart, because the man David understood the importance of giving thanks to God, praising God, worship God. So no wonder if David is a man after God's own heart, I believe that that's one of that. because I'm not on Tassi. You miss one, or do you need open eye? But today, many people join Kwa or joining Sikh.
Amen.
We are sanctified, redeemed by the Lord. The Bible says we are the chosen generation, called by God to show forth His praise unto Him. But do you understand the meaning or the importance of music or giving praise and worship God? Sometimes we used to say that a prayerful church is a powerful church, or a prayerful believer is a powerful believer. It's true. But every church who takes music to a high level is a powerful church.
Amen.
Every believer who understands music, how to sing unto God, how to worship God, is a powerful believer.
Amen.
I remember those days when I sent to God, that I'm not thinking about Bible again. We worship in school day. Now there was a church in Nitakari, a Living Praise Chapel. It was then a powerful church. Now, Yebengaka. Now, say, every time I saw where you worship, because the pastor understood the worship. That time, not up America, so he brought instrument. In Newman, so I saw those place of worship, where you worship. So, I feel a bit of alcohol. That man, I feel like I'm able, but I can see you do it. Boom, 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 boom. And then I feel able, don't do it. Now, when we are worshiping God, praising God, it was powerful. So, music takes a major role in the church. When the church takes it in a high level, God has given to His church, I always used to say that, three combined keys that every believer we need to practice. First, we need to practice fasting and prayer. They go together. We need to practice or give it to God, the tithe and offering. Then have you asked yourself, why God gave the church to praise and worship Him? And worship and praise is more powerful. It's more powerful. Why? Because when we go to heaven, we are not going to give tithe to God. God doesn't need tithe. We are not going to give offering to God. When we go to heaven, we are not going to pray and fast. It will all end here.
Yes.
But when we go to heaven, we are going to worship our Maker.
Amen.
So worship or the music in the house of God is very powerful.
Amen.
God loves music. He loved it. That's what the Bible says when you read Revelation chapter 4, verse 8 to 11. God has specially created the angels. He said that the four creatures, they surround the throne. And all that they do every day, the Bible says, day and night, holy, holy unto the one who is on the throne. 24 good hours, 7 days a week. Romans chapter 5, verse 11 to 14, so I see thousands of angels, the 24 elders, they join them and they sing unto God. So this is what we are going to do in heaven. So if you don't practice here, I don't know what are you going to do there. So God loves music. Hallelujah. That's why I say that I haven't said that mess up and I open up and if you so. Because God is not interested in the voice. God is not interested in the skills that you can do when you are playing instrument. God is after the heart.
Amen.
Your dedication.
Amen.
If you know, I don't think anybody has a mute of a voice and you're better than your friend Satan voice. Another Lucifer voice. That's when you disobey God. God brought him down. So we need to humble ourselves.
Amen.
So that God will exalt us.
Amen.
So from heaven, the Bible says, when God called Moses and the children of Israel, from the land of Egypt. The Bible says God told Moses to call Aaron and his descendants to become priests and the Levites. And the priests, their job is to minister in the inner court, that the Holy of Holies. And the Levites, the Bible referred to them as singers. All that they do is they lead the whole congregation before God. And so when you're meeting Paul, there will be a time that the church will be established. That's why he laid that pattern in the Old Testament time for us to continue. So both the preachers or the priests and the singers, they are all ministers. So in our time, the preachers and the singers, you are all ministers. You know the reason why? Because the preachers minister by the word, but you minister by song. So you are important, just as pastors are important in the sight of God. But because we don't have literal understanding on that, sometimes yeah, maybe biara. Hallelujah. Now, and the premier should answer. I'm not saying we couldn't be. No, we need to change our mind because all that the leaders need is revival.
Amen.
The church need a revival. They to their division. The Levites, who were the singers, all those of Asaph and Heman and the Jubilant, with their sons and their brethren, stood at the east gate, clothed with white linen. So the first thing that I want to talk about is they were clothed with white linen, signified the holiness that we see from them. Then the second thing, that the instrument. And the third thing is that they were as one, that the unity. And the result is the glory of the Lord through the temple. So there are five things that we see here. The priests, the Levites, clothed with linen, that is the holy people. So what brings revival? The first thing I'll talk about is holiness. Come from here. Bible says without holiness, no one will see God. God has given the garment. When you open up my altar, ashes. Then the man tells me, "Ashes, I'm not asking this, no. Don't need to be violent." The revival will not come until we put ourselves to be righteous before God. So anytime God will require people, so be it on board. I'm going to assume what can do. So be it on board. I'm going to look at Kenya. We need to put something aside. Holiness in the house of God is very important. We need to set ourselves apart because you are ministers. If somebody comes here, the first thing the person will see is that you will see the musicians and the singers standing here. It's in the house of God, or in the full. And the ushers know they play major role. Their role is very crucial. So before we can see revival, holiness is one thing. The second thing that I will talk about is unity. Because without unity, we cannot achieve anything. The Bible says they were one, as they are one. To lift their voice unto God. So unity is important. Jesus chapter 17. Jesus compared Amma and Yusufano, and only if it's baby Nana, no pay away in the jar. The man now here about no, the man also wants to be the children. So in the plan, when there is no unity, we cannot see the glory of the Lord. When there is no unity in the leadership, we cannot see the glory of the Lord. So unity is very important if we want to see revival in our midst.
Amen.
That's why Psalm 130 is, okay, no. First, behold, how present It is for the brethren to dwell to be together in unity. So unity takes a major role as we need revival. The third thing that I would say is be a true worshiper.
Amen.
Because sometimes we will be friends with an instrumental, another a singer. But now in his private life, no, you don't worship. So if you call yourself as a singer, regularly, you need to worship God. You need to worship God. May you let your worship become part of you. Let your praises become part of you. Sometimes you go to be again in the team. No, it's a worthy song. But when it comes Sunday, we want to lead the whole congregation to worship God.
Amen.
How can you see the glory of the Lord? If you want to see the glory of the Lord, you are singers now. Be my Emma and Father of Sore and Yusufan. I hear and Yusufan. I be there by your meaning, not by ye, Paman. It's all that a man in Asia. Because we have already charged in our homes. When we come together, we will see the glory of the Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So the importance of music in the house of God. Then the Bible says, the glory of the Lord filled the temple. It is very interesting that the glory of the Lord descended or filled the temple. It says that it filled the house. The house of the Lord. Because they were holy, clothed with holiness, because they were united. That's why the Bible says the glory of the Lord descended in their midst. So when we come together, but because we are not united, because we do things anyhow, because we don't have the understanding of worshiping God, we worship God, we praise God, but we don't see the glory of the Lord in our midst. This is my prayer this morning. That from today, I'm going to move in a special way. So the Bible says, even the priests could not minister because of the glory of the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So before the pastor will mount the pulpit, this place needs to be charged. Because the praise and worship are prepared the way for the pastor, the glory of the Lord will descend.
Amen.
So we need a revival. And revival will come when we are holy. Revival will come when we are united. Revival will come when we set ourselves to worship our Maker. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So to end my message this morning, all that we need is just us, the priests and the singers, just us, the people were one. Just as they raise their voice and worship God, the glory of the Lord is saying, may this be our prayer this morning. As we are going to pray, that the Lord will revive everyone. The Lord will restore the revival in our midst. And from today onwards, our power will not be the same. From today onwards, we will see the power of God moving in the midst of our power. That from today onwards, we will see the power of God moving in the midst of the church.
Yes.
Because sometimes they are praying. Now, so hereby, yes, the man. We need to see the power of God. Just as Pastor is preaching to us every day, that we need to see the power of God. Because when the power of God is moving, then the world will see what God is doing in our midst. And they will come and testify what God is doing in our midst. So, may the Lord bless you this morning.
Amen.
As we be on our feet.
Amen.
To pray and ask the Lord to minister. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are going to pray three prayers for the power and for ourselves.
not for God, we will not be able to stand here. Amen. We thank the Almighty God for what He has done for us in our lives. In fact, what we have witnessed today is great, it's marvelous. Like, other churches also see this too, but our choir has progressed over the years by the grace of God. Amen. Secondly, we want to give thanks to our pastor and daddy of the house and his leaders, his deacons, especially our patron and Deacon Oti for being here for us and helping us through all the things which we have been doing. And it is our prayer that the zeal and the desire and the commitment that we have today, which will go on forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
Lastly, but not least, a special thanks goes to each and every single one of you here, our audience. Like, it's been a pleasure and it's been a grace to perform to you and sing to you and minister to you. Like, it's amazing. Amen. And also, we would like to thank Deacon Oti, the members, Brother Augustine, Auntie Shetty, who has been here for us, who has been a guide for us, as well as all of the other choir members. And also, we'd like to say a very big thank you, and we thank you all for your presence, and may God richly bless you all. Amen.
Amen.